Morning, children. Welcome to your EVS 1 class. So I hope you're doing all well, all fine, you're all healthy and taking good care of yourselves, okay? So today what we are going to do is we are going to do the workbook solutions or workbook exercises. We'll discuss the workbook answers of the chapter 11, food storage, okay? So I have I'll just discuss the answers, and what I want you to do is I want you to write the answers if possible in your own words and submit the workbook answers in the Google Classroom. Okay, all right children, I hope you have taken out your workbook and turned to page number 9 of your workbook. Okay, so see the multiple choice questions, children. The first question is, which of the following is a sign of spoiled food? You have four options. Option A says pleasant smell, good taste, no change in look, and growth of fluffy structure over the food. So children, we know that the growth of fluffy structure over the food, what is that the sign of? That is the sign of growth of fungi over food, right? And that is one thing that spoils the food. So my correct option is option D, that growth of fluffy structure over food means that the food is spoiled, okay? So my first answer is option D. In the second question, you have which of the following items would get spoiled faster? The options are curry, biscuits, chips and wheat grains. Now see children, curry is something we know that gets bad very fast, right? If you have curry for dinner, it will get bad fast within a few hours. But biscuits, chips, wheat grains, if you keep them at a cool dry place, they will last longer. So the correct option is option A. Okay, now go to question number 3. Fill in the blanks. Microorganisms go faster on a hot climate. We know that, right? Because in a hot climate, microorganisms, they can multiply faster and they can spoil the food. So microorganisms grow faster in a hot climate. And also, my question number 4, the correct answer is microorganisms, because microorganisms that spoil food cannot be seen with our naked eyes. Can you give me an example of a microorganism that spoils food faster? Yes, you are right. It is bacteria. Okay, so let's go to the next question. Question number 5. In question number 5, you have that what do we call the food that becomes harmful to our health? Okay, the answer is the food that becomes harmful to our health is called spoiled food, right? Because spoiled food, if you eat them, you will get a tummy ache, right? You'll get food poisoning. So the food that becomes harmful is called spoiled food. Okay. Now what should we check before buying any packaged food items from the market? So children, if you buy any food, any medicines, what do we check? We check for the expiry date or the best before date, right? So we have to check the expiry date or the best before date before we buy any packaged food from the market, right? Now, let's go to the next question. What is food spoilage? Name any one microorganism that spoils food. In food spoilage, the nutrients in the food get spoiled and such food gets wasted. Microorganisms such as bacteria spoil the food. Okay? All right. So let us go to the true and false questions. In olden days, people used natural methods to store and preserve food. Is it correct? Yes, it is. So the answer is true. All right. So let's move to the next question. Question number 9. That is, we put sugar in pickles to preserve them. In pickles, do we add sugar, children? I do not think so. In pickles, we use a lot of salt and vinegar to preserve food. So the answer is false. Question number 10. Ice creams are stored in deep freezers to preserve. Yes, we do keep ice creams in the deep freezers, right? If you take them out, they will melt. And what will happen? They will get spoiled very fast. So ice creams are stored in deep freezers to preserve. The answer is true. Now, leafy vegetables are mostly preserved by drying them in the sun. Do we keep out leafy vegetables out in the sun? Not at all. I do not think so. So the answer is false. Okay. Let us move to the short answer questions. What is food storage? Question number 12. Why is it important? So we learned that storing food for later use is called food storage, right? And food storage is very important to avoid wastage of food, right, children? Because if we store food, we will not be wasting them. Okay, so question number 13, let's move on. All right, how are the following food items stored? Food grains like rice and wheat, how do we store them? We had discussed in our class, right, that we store them in dry containers. And milk is something that we store in refrigerators to keep it cool and last longer. Okay, all right. So let us move to the long answer questions. Okay, question number 14. We preserve food to use it later. Based on the answer, answer the following questions. Question number 1. What is food preservation? So children, do you remember what is food preservation? Food preservation are the steps taken to keep the food fresh and nutrient rich, right? When you preserve food, the food remains fresh and the nutrients are also remain in the food, right? Now question number B. Identify the method of food preservation shown below. In the first picture, you can see a lot of chilies drying out in the sun, right? So the process is drying in the sun. In the second picture, you can see, I think it is a mango pickle, right? So in the mango pickles, okay, how do we preserve them? By pickling, okay? All right, so let's move to the next part. In the first picture, you can see it's a picture of jams, right? And how are jams preserved? By using sugar and jaggery to make jams. So that is the preservation technique. And in the next picture, you have the picture of a freezer, deep freezer. So the process is deep freezing. Okay, all right. So question number 15, multiple choice questions. Which of the following adds texture to the food and preserves it well? So which of them preserves food, children? Storing in the plastic container is a method of food storage, right? Not food preservation. So if we add a lot of sugar to the fruits, they can be preserved. So the answer is option B. Okay. In question number 16, which of the following methods is used to get mango jellies throughout the year? Okay. So mango jellies is one thing, children. We keep it in little cans, right? If you go to the market, you will see a lot of mangoes that are kept in cans. So the answer is canning, because canning is a process where you add a lot of sugar in little cans and you can store them, okay? So the answer is canning. Now go to question number 17. That's also a short answer question that Rita wants to know what happens to food if we do not use any preservation methods. Explain it to her. So children, what will happen when you do not use any preservation techniques on the food? The food will get bad very fast, right? So we can say that the food will spoil very easily in a very short time. Okay. For question number 18, how can we make seasonal food available throughout the year? All right, remember? Yes, remember, mango is a seasonal food that is available only on summers. So if we preserve them, then what will happen? We will be able to eat mangoes all throughout the year. So I can say that by using various preservation methods, we can make seasonal food available throughout the year. Okay. All right, so let's move on. All right, so in question number 17, we have why do we preserve mangoes? All right, use the mangoes as hints, or use the images as hints. Okay, so in the first picture, you have a mango tree in the winter and the mango tree in the summer. Do we have mangoes in the winter? No, we don't. So I can say that the reason that we preserve mangoes is to enjoy it in other seasons as well as it is a seasonal fruit. Okay. So we preserve mangoes. Why do we do that? to enjoy it in other seasons because mango is a seasonal food, okay? And in the second picture, you have a picture of pudding, then you have a picture of a juice, and you have cans, okay? All right, and why do we do that? Why do we make mangoes into a pickle or into a jam, into juice? Why do we do that? To enjoy it in different textures and flavors and increase its nutritional value. So when we add a lot of sugar, a lot of spices, it gets very tasty. So we can enjoy it in different textures and flavors and increase its nutritional value. Okay. Now let's move on to the next question. Question number 20. All right. So what do we have here? We carry food items when we travel. What precautions should we take to prevent the food from getting spoiled? Use the given hints. Okay, so in the first picture, we have a lot of dry fruits, right? So when we travel, children, when we go for picnics, we use a lot of dry food. So why do we do that? We care. So when we should travel, we should carry more dry foods with us, right? So the answer is carry more of the dry food items. Okay. So in the second picture, you know, you can see food in a package, right? So what care should be taken for packaging cooked food, right? So when we are packing cooked food, we have to make sure that the food is not very hot, okay? If it is very hot, then what will happen? The bacteria and microbes, they will grow very fast and they will spoil the food, okay? What packaging care? Okay, so what care should be taken while packaging the food? All right, so we have to pack the food items in such a way that water cannot get in, right? If the water gets in, again the food will become spoiled, okay? And in the third picture, you have storing the packaged items. All right, so how do we store the packaged items? We have to keep it in a cool, dry place and we have to keep it away from the sunlight. Okay, children? All right, so you have to please write the answers down in your workbook and send it to me in Google Classroom, okay? All right. Okay, children, so I hope the answers are clear to you. Please write them down in your workbook, and if the workbook space is not enough, write it out in your copies and please submit it in the Google Classroom, okay? I'll post this chapter as an assignment, all right? So I hope everything is clear, and I'll see you in the next class. Thank you.